Hi, so today we're going to be talking about the Spline Length Node. This node will allow you to make changes with the information of the length or the amount of points of each spline, and I'll explain it to you in a graphic way. Okay, so before starting, I would just like to remind you that I have a playlist where I'm adding the information about all of the geometry nodes, and the link is in the description. I'll also like to encourage you to like this video and subscribe. Okay, so in this short tutorial, the first thing that we're going to be doing is that we're going to erase this cube, and there we're going to be adding a curve, a Bézier curve. And then we're going to be getting closer, and we're going to go to edit mode. We're going to select all the curve, and then we're going to duplicate the spline. And this first spline, we're going to be scaling it. We're going to select the first spline again. We're going to duplicate it. And this one, we're going to be subdividing it. You're going to know why in a moment. Now we're going to go to geometry nodes. We're going to create a new node. And then we're going to be adding an instance on points. As you see, all of the splines disappeared. So we're going to be adding a join geometry node to be able to see everything. Now we're going to be adding the points of the instance on points. And now we're going to get a little bit closer to see what's going to happen. And after that, we're going to be adding the spline length node. And we're going to connect it to the scale. So here is the important thing. The two splines that have the same length have the same size of points, but the spline that has a bigger length has a bigger size of points. Now, if we set it to take the point count of the splines, it's going to be changing. The spline that has a bigger amount of points is the one that has a bigger scale in the points, and the splines that have only two points have the same size of points. That's the information that this node is taking. It's giving you the information of the length of each spline or of the point count, the amount of points of each spline. So tell me in the comments what you think can be done with this node, and maybe I'll do it. By now, that'll be it. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.